rejected British HMS Queen Elizabeth class aircraft carrier. What was the reason behind it? If you want to know about this, then this video is for you. So let's get started. So, the reason why India rejected HMS Queen Elizabeth class carrier, we'll discuss this. First, we need to know the technical specifications. So, there are four types of aircraft carriers. So, what aircraft carriers are? They are like a sea-going airbase, because in the sea also they can make the aircraft take off and land. So, like there are small military base in the sea. So, there are four types of aircraft carrier. First is STOVL. STOVL means short take off and vertical landing. So the short takeoff and vertical landing, it can only be done by two aircraft in the world right now, that is Sea Harrier and F-35 Lightning II, or you can say F-35D. So these two are the only aircraft in the world that can do vertical landing and takeoff, out of which Sea Harrier is very old. So F-35 is the only one available now, and it is very expensive, so that's why. And then there is STOBAR. The STOBAR stands for short take off but arrested recovery. So in this, arresting system is used, like there is a hook behind the aircraft which has to attach with the wire on the aircraft carrier, and it will stop the aircraft in 2 seconds. Then there is CATOBAR, that is catapult assisted takeoff but arrested recovery. In this also, arrested recovery used. So in the STOBAR, what happens, instead of keeping the aircraft carriers on the front straight, they keep it a bit elevated. So what happens is, it helps the aircraft go nicely. But then what happens is, the aircraft needs to put a lot of force to get up, and that's why India uses MiG-29, which has a very nice thrust ratio. In CATOBAR, what happens is, they put the aircraft straight only. They use a catapult system which throws the aircraft like a slingshot at a speed of 180 km per hour. Then there is VTOL, that is also known as helicopter carriers or amphibious assault ships. So VTOL stands for vertical takeoff and landing. So the VTOL supports only these two aircraft, out of which Sea Harrier is old, so we will eliminate this. So only F-35 Lightning II is left now, and this is a very expensive fighter jet. It almost costs $115 million. So what here happened was that HMS Queen Elizabeth was STOVL type aircraft carrier. So like, it can't use the arrested recovery system, but Britain then said that we'll modify according to India's terms and conditions. But it is better that India puts that it will take a time and money for the Britain to do it. So India thought it better, we will put the time on INS Vishal, which is a CATOBAR type aircraft carrier. Then our Vikramaditya and Vikrant, which are so Vikramaditya in service, Vikrant will enter in the service by the end of this year. So they both are STOBAR. So instead of wasting time and money on the HMS Queen Elizabeth, India decided that we will put this time in INS Vishal, which is a CATOBAR. So currently only two countries have CATOBAR system, that is United States and France. So these two are the only countries that have CATOBAR system, and the rest countries have these three types of system, that is STOVL, STOBAR and VTOL. So mostly STOBAR is used. The Chinese aircraft carriers also use STOBAR. Then the Russian carriers use STOBAR. Italian carriers are STOVL type. Then HMS Queen Elizabeth STOVL. The France, Charles de Gaulle, it is CATOBAR. Then all American Nimitz class carriers and Gerard Ford class carriers are CATOBAR. And vertical takeoff carriers are with the small countries like Spain. Then our Thailand. So like vertical takeoff carriers, these are mostly used as helicopter carriers. So that was the main reason India rejected HMS Queen Elizabeth class carrier. So this was my video for today. I hope you like my video. Please like my video.